Rintaro Okabe is a first-year student from the Tokyo Denki University, which he attends with Itaru. Although he looks close to 24 to 25 in the anime, Rintaro is actually 18 years old. That's quite a young age for a mad scientist. Welcome to Anime Extra. In today's video, we're going over the life of Rintaro Okabe. Before we begin, we publish new videos every week, so be sure to subscribe to our channel and ring the bell to get notified about our latest videos. Rintaro's actual age may be confusing for a lot of viewers because of the sheer number of time jumps in Steins Gate. During the original Steins Gate, we haven't seen Rintaro interact with any of his family members. Add to the fact that during the original series, we hardly get any details about his family, apart from the fact that they have a privately owned business. He also gets a Christmas gift in the form of an eggplant from his family, but that's all we know. Rintaro and Shiina Mayuri are co-founders of the Future Gadget Laboratory, a research institute geared towards creating devices which would help mankind. Their laboratory is located in Rintaro's rented room above a CRT television shop in Akihabara district in Tokyo, Japan. Fun fact! The anime accurately depicts the culture of Akihabara in Tokyo, Japan. There are several real-life landmarks, cosplay conferences, Rinet board game tournaments, and maid cafes featured in the series. Rintaro appears to be eccentric and socially inept, as he often misses common social cues. But on the other hand, he's known to go out of his way to help others, which shows empathy. His Hoin Kiyoma persona is a facade which he puts on, where he's often seen pretending to talk over the phone to avoid facing his problems. The viewers get to see his Chunibyu aura in its entirety when he's faced by Mayuri's numerous incidents that take place across multiple timelines, something he tries preventing desperately through the acquisition of the IBM 5100 computer. Fun fact, although based in the genre of science fiction, Steins Gate is a well-researched series. In fact, John Titor, who is known to be the originator of the time machine theory, was a real person who claimed to be from the year 2038, and he was seeking an IBM 5100 PC from 1975 as a way to save the future, although the show called this PC the IBN 5100. Rintaro calls himself Lab Member Number 001, as he's the first person to join the team, and all subsequent members are given increasingly higher numbers. Mayuri, his childhood friend, becomes Lab Member Number 002. During his time in the lab, Rintaro ends up creating a gadget called the Phone Microwave, which is capable of sending text messages back in time, although he isn't aware of how it works at first, leading his own fate into a spiral of going back and forth in time to fix things. Fun fact, the anime was originally adapted from a video novel, which was then turned into a manga before finally becoming the anime that fans have come to love. Although Okabe sometimes acts like a tsundere, he is known to care for the people around him as the series progresses. In fact, we get to see his caring and warm side when he repeatedly tries to undo Mayuri's death, without thinking about his own well-being. He often shows characteristics of a villain, displaying symptoms of delusion and paranoia, or bursting into maniacal laughter, and bringing his personality closer to that of a mad scientist. Later on in the series, though, we learn that this is a front to make his life seem more interesting to Mayuri. Rintaro likes to boast that he is working against a certain organization who is out to get him, when in reality, it's another front to make him seem cooler in the eyes of his friends. However, fiction later becomes reality as it is later revealed that there is in fact an organization called CERN who's after him. CERN is looking to create their own version of the time machine. Okabe's sheer genius, along with his ability to remember altered timelines in vivid details, gives him the upper hand over CERN. Okabe calls this ability Reading Steiner, although fans will argue that the other lab members are responsible for the inventions, while Okabe's greatest skill is actually putting together a competent team and helping them work together. Steins Gate shows us that although Rintaro is exceptionally intelligent and talented, his lack of social awareness often leads him being easily deceived by others. How it all began. The main plot of the series begins when Rintaro attends a seminar by Professor Shoichi Makise, which talks about the theory of creating a potential time machine. As he enters the hall, he notices that the building is shaking as if an earthquake is taking place, and he runs upstairs where he finds a satellite on the roof. He then goes back to the seminar and accuses the professor of plagiarizing the work of John Titor, who had given a strikingly similar lecture over one decade ago. Rintaro is then ejected from the seminar and meets Makise Kurisu, who claims to have met him 15 minutes back. As Rintaro is talking to Mayuri, they hear a sharp scream upstairs. As they go to investigate the noise, they find the body of Makise Kurisu covered in a pool of blood. Traumatized by the incident, Rintaro sends a text to his college buddy Itaru Daru Hashida. As soon as the message is sent, all the people on the street suddenly disappear, and the crashed satellite is shown on the roof of the radio tower once more. This leads to a series of events which push Rintaro and his team towards finding ways to fix the broken past. Over the course of the series, we see Rintaro continue to work in his future gadget lab along with his fellow lab members. They end up inventing quite a few gadgets, including the phone wave, a way to send emails in the past. Rintaro's greatest challenge is to create gadgets, which according to him will destroy the control structure of the world. He believes that a secret organization continues to hold its grip over the world, and that a time machine is the only thing that can destabilize this control and prevent World War III. Although it seems that Okabe is being delusional in the beginning, as the series progresses, we learn that he's a lot closer to the truth than we originally thought. The biggest twist comes towards the end of Steins Gate, where Okabe learns that he has to trick his future self into believing that Kurisu is dead in order to save her life and prevent the arms race. He creates a light-up sword-like device loaded with fake blood to execute this plan, but when it comes time to execute, the blood mysteriously seems to dry up. In response, he provokes Nakabachi to stab him. Rintaro then knocks out Kurisu and plants his own blood from his stab wound on her, making his past self believe that Kurisu has actually died, eventually saving her life. During the conclusion of Steins Gate, we learn that Okabe turns even more twisted over time, and viewers are presented with two alternate endings, where Okabe has to choose between saving either Suzuha or Mayuri. Although he develops feelings for Ruka, Raris, Mayuri, and Kurisu, he ends up confessing his love towards Kurisu, regardless of the chosen ending. The romance between Okabe and Kurisu ends up playing a significant role in subsequent Steins Gate sequels. We learn towards the end of the series that Suzuha is in fact John Teeter, the originator of the time travel theory. It is revealed Suzuha is from the year 2036, and she travels to 2010 in a time machine which was mistaken as the crashed satellite at the beginning of the show. Things get even wackier as we learn that Suzuha is a part of a resistance movement against CERN, along with an older Rintaro and Daru, who is her father. Fun fact, Steins Gate is filled with pop culture references including Death Note, Pokemon, JoJo's Bizarre Adventure, Portal, Star Wars, and even Metal Gear Solid throughout the series. In fact, the Back to the Email and DeLorean Mail are both Back to the Future references. Did you enjoy our video? Make sure to check out these other great videos from Anime Extra. And be sure to subscribe and hit the bell to be notified of all our latest videos.